How Beetle Got Her Colors, a folktale from Brazil. There are many interesting and colorful beetles all around the world, but in Brazil, there is a beetle so beautiful to behold that it sometimes appears to be a polished gem. They say, however, that this was not always so. There was a time when beetle was plain. Beetle was ordinary. Beetle was the color of the earth. Indeed, she looked like a small stone when she walked on the ground. It was easy for other creatures to accidentally step on her. Beetle had learned to be careful and to walk on the side of the path so she could be out of everyone's way. Most creatures didn't pay attention to Beetle, so she was able to go about the world without much trouble. But, well, one gray rat seemed to enjoy going out of his way to torment Beetle. Rat looked for Beetle every day, and when he found her, he teased her. "Beetle," he would say, "Beetle, you are plain, you are ordinary, you are not nearly as handsome as I am. Look at me. I have soft gray fur, a long tail, and two lovely ears. What do you have that's special?" "Nothing. You are so plain. No one even sees you." While this hurt Beetle's feelings, she tried to pay no attention to the awful things Rat said to her. Her mother had told her to ignore anyone who teased her, and eventually they would get bored and go away, so Beetle ignored Rat. I am sorry to say this, but that did not stop Rat from looking for Beetle every day and say mean things to her. One day, as he ran up to Beetle, dust spread out from his feet when he screeched to a halt. This caused Beetle to cough, but Rat didn't say he was sorry. Instead, he said to Beetle, "Beetle, you are so slow. You hardly move at all. Look at how fast I can run. I can run circles around you. You are plain and you are slow." Now, all this had been overheard by a parrot sitting in a tree overhead. Parrot knew how Rat had been teasing Beetle for days. Parrot called down to the Rat and Beetle, "Rat, Beetle, I suggest you have a contest. To the winner I will award a handmade coat of any color. The winner will get a coat, and the loser will agree not to bother the winner again." Rat was delighted. A contest! He loved contests! Rat asked Parrot what kind of contest he had in mind. He said, "Look, I win every contest I ever enter, so you might as well forget about a contest and just give me the prize." Beetle just looked up at Parrot and wondered what he was up to. Parrot said, "Do you see that mango tree over there? Whoever can get to the mango tree first will be the winner." Rat was disappointed. "Is that all? Come on! Why not hold a race that at least will be a challenge to win? Beetle doesn't have a chance." "We will see," said Parrot. Rat replied, "Okay, as long as I'm gonna win, you might as well get started on my coat. I'm already about as handsome as I can be, but I think I'd look even better with a red line starting at the top of my head, running down my back and out my tail. Everyone will know it's me if they see the red stripe. When are we going to have this race of yours? I want to win my new coat right away." Parrot asked the two contestants to line up under the tree where he was sitting, and he started the countdown. 1, 2, 3, and off sped Rat. He took off so fast that a cloud of dust could be seen behind him. He turned around and looked, but he didn't see a sign of Beetle. "Oh, boy, this is fun. I'm gonna have a great coat. I think I'll ask for 2 blue dots, too. Yeah, a blue dot on each of my shoulders. That'll look great with my red stripe." As soon as Rat got to the mango tree, he was stunned to see Beetle waiting for him. "Huh? How did you get here? Did you cheat?" "No," said Beetle. "Well then, how'd you get here so fast?" Beetle lifted up her hard shell to reveal two beautiful, delicate wings, and she said, "Well, I flew."
"You flew? I didn't know you could fly."
"Well, you never asked me," said Beetle.
And with that, Rat crawled away to find a rotten old log to hide in.
As Rat left, Parrot called after him.
"Rat, I hope you've learned something today. Even the plainest creatures have something very special about them. Next time you might want to get to know others before you even think about teasing."
Then Parrot asked Beetle what sort of a coat she would like to have.
Well, Beetle had not had time to even think about a coat.
But as she looked up at Parrot and saw his beautiful colors, she wondered what it would be like to look so wonderful. As she was looking at Parrot, Beetle noticed the green leaves in the trees all around. And as she was considering all these different colors of green, a bit of sunlight came through the leaves, making the trees sparkle. She asked Parrot,
"May I have a coat of green, a mix of all the wonderful greens of the trees? And may I have a little bit of sunlight, too?"
From that day to this, the beetles in Brazil have shells of different colors of green with a little bit of sunlight mixed in. Their shells are so lovely and shiny, they resemble precious gemstones. And that is how they say the beetles in Brazil got to be so very beautiful.